I'm a teacher of physics and I work in both elementary school with kids aged 12 to 15 and in high school with kids aged 15 to 19. Well, this activity was designed to be split in three parts. And the first part is great for elementary schools. It requires basically no knowledge prior to it, as we inspect the sound, we measure different sound sources, we inspect their frequency and others. The second part of activity, however, depends on the knowledge of the students from waves, especially standing waves, as they are the part of the guitar sound making process. So it will be important for students to learn something about the waves before setting to part two of this activity. What we did was very simple. We recorded the sound from different sources, sound fork, guitar, violin and other things, and we inspected them to a software for spectral analysis, which is easily available for smartphones, computers. The first part went extremely well. For the first time I was able to show my kids in real time what spectrum is, what's the difference between the tone and the sound that we are hearing. Usually it would end up with some graphics or books illustration, but this time they could really create the sound and inspect it at the same time. My first advice would be sure to try it at home. Different programs are giving different results, they might not be all best for you. Try to see what really works for you and for your class, how do you want it, simple, more complicated, think about it. First part can be done in elementary school with no problem. It can be done by school teachers, teachers from high school, it's really beautiful. Second part, however, requires the more sophisticated level of knowledge in the waves, and that's more high school material. Third part, that's advanced level, and it combines two different theories, elasticity, Hooke's law, and of course the waves and the music. For the first part of activity, 15 minutes is the greatest time. It's your imagination is the only limit you have. The second part, however, would require a little more time, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, depending from how students are skilled in creating graphs. And the third part of this activity is intended to the students that are well-versed in laboratory work.